giving the community a voice. Haiver FM, Howe Community Radio.
Welcome to another Heids and Herts Scotland podcast. Our charity was founded in June 2021 to create, inspire and promote social connections through community arts projects in the Howe and wider North East Fife. We are working with communities impacted by the gradual dismantling of local infrastructure and services, lack of housing, limited transport links, and the integration into our everyday lives of digital technology, contributing to social isolation and loneliness. There has been a lot of research on the effects of loneliness on our mental and physical health. It's seen as one of the biggest health concerns we face. Loneliness is as harmful to our health as smoking 15 cigarettes a day. Heids and Herts are working alongside local people and groups to build a programme of cultural activities based in the village halls. Governments and organisations such as WHO have researched the evidence supporting the value of the arts to alleviate loneliness. This can take many different forms, everything from singing to painting to writing. There are no age requirements for experiencing these benefits.
Hi there, thank you for tuning in again. My name is Ian Harrower and I'm the chair of Heids and Herts Scotland. We return to more edited highlights of our chum Ben Anderson shows, which he recorded for us last May during our Haiver FM Howe Community Radio project and part of 10 hours of daily community centre broadcasts, which we transmitted across the Howe of Fife around Mental Health Awareness Week and from the Jubilee Hall in Burnturk. Ben returned to his home village of Newburgh, where he wove interviews with local creative people into his two-hour shows, which were also packed with top-drawer music choices. Unfortunately, music copyright issues mean we are unable to include those tunes in this podcast. This episode features Ben talking to a wonderful lady, Tricia Anderson, who is a local dancer, teacher, choreographer and animation teacher. Oh, and she's also Ben's mum. The Andersons are one heck of a creative family.
The next interview of the show, and it is with a lovely lady called Tricia Anderson, who I'll tell you more about as I introduce the interview. So I'm here with Tricia Anderson in her home in Newburgh. Tricia grew up in Dunblane with three brothers, including a twin brother and one sister. She moved to Fife from Edinburgh in 1979 to Pitton Weem and taught for many years as a visiting PE teacher for primary schools around Fife. She has always had a keen interest in dance, having choreographed many pieces over the years, including House of Dreams, Time to Go and Festivalba, and has been doing regular inclusive dance class called Do Your Thing. She now lives in Newburgh and has been the chair of the Orchard Group for the last 3 years, and she's also my wonderful mum. So, Tricia, how has your life changed creatively since moving to Newburgh, and how have you felt being part of such an interesting community?
I think the biggest thing that's probably changed for me is the fact that we have an orchard alongside the garden. We have a wonderful big space here, but there are a lot of fruit trees out there that need a lot of care. So one of the big things that's happened for me is that I've learned how to look after them, how to prune them, and then what to do with all the fruit. So I've learned to make all sorts of things, dry apples, make apple juice. I've even had a go at cider, not successfully, I have to say. And then for us inside, the space inside is really a nourishing one. So there's space to dance, there's space to move, and there's space to have people have a party.
Sounds like fun. So you're also actively involved in the Newburgh Orchard Group, as you say. How important is fruit in Newburgh, and what has been your role, and how can other people get involved?
Before I was the chair, I think I was very much involved because I'm a teacher already, so I have those skills. So teaching the children about the fruit, it's important because it's one of the few towns in Scotland which has a huge amount of fruit trees, over 1,000 trees, all in private gardens, 85 of which are in a community orchard. So the community orchard is next door to the school. So inevitably, you know, it makes life very easy for teaching the children what to do with the apples, how to make dried apples, how to look after the fruit, what kind of fruit's there. And we even make apple juice with them.
Okay, and how can people in the community get more involved with the orchard group and the fruit of Newburgh?
Well, there's a website, Newburgh Orchard Group, and there's a Facebook page. We do pruning sessions in the winter, and we have fruit fairs in the summer. And this year, again, we're going to do an apple day, which we did just before lockdown, where people can come along to the church at the end of October and learn all about the fruit. So we're trying to really persuade the people in Newburgh who have fruit to use it. A lot of it goes to waste, so trying to give them ideas about what to do with it.
Cool. Dancing has always been a big part of your life. Does the local area inspire you to dance more? What would you say to someone wanting to start dancing? And do you still have plans to start a dance class in Newburgh?
Well, I when I was young, I was a sprinter. So I was a very fast runner, a good jumper, but I also loved art. So it was always a difficult choice for me. And I ended up doing a dance degree. So doing dance and moving and dance in a way is a perfect combination for me of art and movement. I think it's an important way to express. For me, it's a really good form of expression. So you know, working with music is also really beneficial. Everybody can dance. The group that I work with at Scottish Dance Theatre are a huge range of ages, from 19 up to 60 is our oldest. Some in wheelchairs, some who can move around really well. It's just a big part of their lives. And yes, I'd love to start a class in Newburgh, or certainly in the surrounding area, for people to be creative with their bodies and to learn to move and express themselves. Nothing is right or wrong, just to be.
What is it about Newburgh, in your opinion, that sets it apart from other towns? What drew you here in the first place, and what do you love most?
Well, I think the fact that it's on the river. I mean, from anywhere in our house or garden, we look out across the River Tay. And also, we look towards Perthshire, which is where I was born. So it's lovely to be in Fife, but looking at Perthshire, so having that roundabout. And there's a lovely, the older generation in Newburgh are very friendly, interested in people. There's no airs and graces. People just are what they are. There's a real variety. A lot of creative people in Newburgh. It's got interesting wines up and down. Lots of little secret places. Lovely places to walk up the hill, along the river.
You did a master's in animation and visualization in 2010. And on the back of that, you were also an artist in residence at Duncan of Jordanston College of Art in Dundee. Tell us about the connection to Norman McLaren, the app that you developed, and how this whole new chapter changed your life.
Yes, well, I learned Norman McLaren was my father's cousin, and I was always quite interested in what he'd done. I discovered that he was so interested in movement when he went to art college in Glasgow that when he was given an idea for using a camera, he started making films and realised he could make movement. And much, much later in an interview, he said if he had been living in New York when he was 10, he probably would have danced. And if he danced, he probably would have become a choreographer, because he loved to create things with movement. And I realised as a dancer that it might be interesting to make a piece of work about his life. His centenary was coming up in 2014. So I started looking at all his films and speaking to other relatives. And in the end, I applied to do a master's, and my idea was to look at his life and my life as a dancer, to look at what the connections were, and to realise there were so many genetic things that we shared. So I ended up making a film, basically, about him and about letters. I found over 400 letters that he wrote home over the time between when he left for New York in 1939, just as the war started, to when he died in 1987. And using these, I interpreted them in dance. And then I learned to animate as well, just a simple hand-drawn animation.
Brilliant. If anyone is interested in dance, the Orchard Group, or animation, how can people connect with you?
Well, I think if you mentioned earlier, you mentioned the app. So basically during his centenary, the National Film Board of Canada developed an app called McLaren's Workshop. It's a really nice first place to start for people who'd like to learn about animation. And I can be found in Newburgh on Facebook.
Okay, great. And finally, I've asked you if you'd like to choose a song for the show. Can you tell us what you've chosen, who it's by, and why you've chosen this song?
Well, on my Saturday class, I have someone called Bob in the class who is just passionate about Scottish traditional music. We both love Julie Fowlis. Bob was the only person during the Big Tent Festival many years ago. Somebody came rushing up to me and said, Aberfeldy are on and there's only one person dancing and he's in a wheelchair. And I knew exactly who that would be. So Bob just lets himself go and loves music. So Touch the Sky from Brave, which Julie Fowlis sings, for us has the perfect combination of a Scottish traditional music and a theme about no matter what you feel you're restricted by in life, let yourself go, just be yourself and fly.
Brilliant, great message. Tricia, Mum, thank you very much for talking to me, and looking forward to playing you on Haiver FM.
Very welcome, thank you.
Thanks to Ben and Tricia, and we'll continue to share more of these special edits of Ben's interviews with the fascinating creative people of Newburgh in further episodes. Now, people get to hear about and find podcasts like this one if you share it, rate it, and talk about it. Please follow us on our YouTube channel, Facebook page, and watch out for information on a new project coming soon, and find out how you can become involved in making podcasts about creative and fascinating people in your community. And finally, let's play out with a section of that lovely track mentioned by Tricia, featuring Julie Fowlis, and the track Touch of the Sky from the movie soundtrack Brave.
Haiver FM, Howe Community Radio, is supported by the Fife Community's Mental Health and Wellbeing Fund through Fife Voluntary Action and the Scottish Government.